Hi guys, my name is Robbie Ferry and welcome to my channel. So I wanted to do a video today about turbo trainers and how annoyingly noisy they are. So I got mine about 6-7 months ago. It was a Miele Zumo direct drive turbo trainer and I thought it was going to be super quiet and super easy to get all my training done through winter, but it didn't actually work out like that. So when I actually got the trainer, I set it up in here. I put a spare bike I had on it, and that day I started training. And the first thing my missus said to me was, "Wow, that's a loud bit of kit." And because she works from home sometimes, I thought, actually, this isn't going to be very pleasant for her. Then, probably a few weeks after that, I went out to walk my dog, and my neighbours came out and said, "You've got that washing machine on a lot, haven't you?" And I was like, So one of the first things I did was I got a mat. This isn't an actual turbo training mat. This was just a very thick sports mat and I put it under my turbo trainer. And not only did it catch the sweat and catch some of the oil off the chain and stuff like that, it actually really quietened the turbo trainer down quite a lot. And I found it just absorbed some of that vibration, some of that shake. So the first tip I can give you is to get a really nice thick mat to go under your turbo trainer. The second tip I can give you is to put a new chain and cassette on the bike when you set it up on your turbo trainer. Degrease it, clean it, get everything as smooth and efficient as possible, and it will make such a difference to the noise of your turbo trainer. The next thing I did was take my turbo from upstairs here to downstairs here. And you're probably wondering what difference that made. So if you can get your turbo onto a really nice, secure floor, that will absorb most of the vibration and most of the sound. So I took my turbo from upstairs, which was a wooden floor, to downstairs, which was concrete and tiles, and I found that the concrete and the tiles absorbed all the noise, but when it was on the wood, it actually amplified all the noise. And the next tip I can give you is to try and use workout mode with the ERG. So if you're not sure what ERG is, it's where the turbo will automatically change the resistance for you while you stay in the same gear. So because of this, you can actually position the chain anywhere on your cassette you want, giving a cleaner chain line, making it a lot quieter. So the difference you'll find is, so you can go from this to this instead, which is a heck of a lot quieter. And I'm still giving the same amount of watts to the bike as it deserves. So hopefully there's a tip or two in there that'll help get your turbo trainer at home quieter, meaning you get less grief off the neighbours and your family. If you liked this video, guys, don't forget to subscribe and thank you for watching.